Good morning. My name is Betsy Heading, and I'm here this morning to share a brief update on Emmanuel's Circle of Welcome team. I'm guessing that many of you are as horrified as I am with the unfolding crisis in Ukraine that has caused so many families, millions of families, to be separated. So it's really easy to forget that just 7 months ago, there was a similar humanitarian crisis in Afghanistan, as 80,000 Afghans were evacuated to the United States. They were evacuated because they had either worked with the U.S. military or they worked with U.S. humanitarian organizations. Since September, Minnesota has resettled 750 of these Afghans. Supporting refugees is part of our Lutheran tradition. Lutheran Immigration and Refugee Service is the largest faith-based nonprofit that's doing this work. Today, Lutheran congregations help support this work by establishing Circles of Welcome teams. Emmanuel's Circle of Welcome team is providing friendship and mentoring to our Afghan family friends as they begin to navigate the challenges of settling in a new country. Our five friends are ages 20 to 34 years old, and they have left behind four wives, one fiance, and 14 young children. They live in two apartments in Bloomington. Our team, which includes eight Emmanuel members, first met our friends on March 28th. Since then, we've had a crash course in the challenges that are facing our friends as they navigate their new lives. The most ongoing and consistent challenge is communication. Most of them speak Pashto. So we've developed kind of a crude communication system where we translate something into Pashto and Google Translate and then put it into WhatsApp. And it's worked fairly well, but there definitely have been some messages that have been lost in translation. For that reason, we are hiring an interpreter to come with us when we meet once a week with our friends to begin to try to understand their needs and help prioritize our work. One of the first things that we were able to do when we understood some of their needs was help get them refurbished bikes. And they are using these bicycles as they travel to work. They're working night shifts, and previous to that, they were walking a half hour to the bus stop, getting on the bus, getting off the bus stop, and then walking to work. We have some other needs that we've identified, and Savannah has set up a sign-up genius that is located on the Circle of Welcome page on Emmanuel's website. Beyond these initial requests, we're really still working to ascertain what are the most important ways and helpful ways that we can support them and accompany them as they move towards self-sufficiency. And so we'll continue to update our congregation about ways that you can help support them as well. But thank you so much already for your generosity. We would invite you, if you want to make a welcome card, Grace will have a table set up where families or children can make a welcome card, and we will deliver these to our friends. And if you're interested in learning more about what our team is doing, you can contact Gina Gerard, our team leader, or any of the members of the team, and our names are all listed on the Circle of Welcome webpage. Finally, we invite your prayers for our five friends and for our team as we remember Jesus' word in Matthew 25, verse 34. Five, for I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink, and you welcomed me. Thank you very much.